Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad and welcome to another video on C programming language. In this video, we will see how we can compile and run a C program from the command prompt. Now, if you want to run a C program in your computer, then you need to install the C toolset. Now, all these things are explained in separate videos. I'm gonna put the link in the description box and you guys can check that out. I'm using the Windows operating system and I am using MinGW. MinGW stands for Minimalist GNU for Windows. And when you install this MinGW, you get the compiler, linker, and all these programs so that you can create a C program and generate an executable file from that, and you can execute that program. So the first thing that we do here is we will check whether we have properly installed and configured the MinGW. Now, I have already installed the CodeBlocks IDE along with the MinGW, and if you want to watch a tutorial and install it on your computer, then I'm going to put the link in the description box and you guys can check it out. Now, I'm going to open up the command prompt and here we will check the GCC version installed. So it will be GCC minus minus version. Now, if you're using any other toolset other than GCC, then you may need to use different commands. You guys can check out their documentation. Okay, now if I hit the enter button, I get the error saying that GCC is not recognized as an internal or the external command. Now, if you get this error, then it means that you may not have installed the GCC in your computer, MinGW in your computer, or you may not have set the path environment variable. Now, I have installed the CodeBlocks IDE along with the MinGW. So the MinGW is installed in my computer, but I have not set the path environment variable so that I can access that program from any other location. Now, if you don't get this error message here, if you can see the version of the GCC installed, then you can skip to the part of the video where I'll be start writing the code. I'm gonna put the timestamp for that in the description. You guys can go there and you guys can click on that. And you can start watching the video from that point onwards. Now, in order to set the path environment variable, first we need to find the location where we have installed the MinGW. Here, I have installed it. Before that, let me close this command prompt. Okay, now I have installed the MinGW in my C drive in this program files x86. And here, CodeBlocks folder. And inside that, you guys can see MinGW. Open that up and go to bin folder. And now we need this path. I'm gonna left click on this URL section or the address bar. And then I'm gonna copy this location, which will be C program files x86, CodeBlocks MinGW bin, okay? Now we know where this MinGW is installed. Now we will set the path environment variable. Now to do that, I'm gonna right click on this PC icon and then I'll go to properties. Okay. Now here, I'm gonna go to advanced system settings. And then you will see environment variables. Click on that. Now it will open up this one. And here you guys can see system variables. Now scroll down and you will see path. Select that by left clicking on that. And then click on edit, and then it will open up another window. And here you guys can see the various programs paths specified here. Now we will add the path for the MinGW installation location, which we have copied. So we will click on this new, and then we will paste that path that we have copied, which is C program files x86, CodeBlocks MinGW bin. Once you do that, click on OK. Click on OK again and click on this OK again, and you guys can close this window. Okay, now we have set the path environment variable with the location where we have installed the MinGW. Now if I open up the command prompt and if I type in the command GCC minus minus version, and then you guys can see now since we have set the path environment variable for the MinGW installation location, we can call that command from any folder, okay? Now we will write a simple C program and then compile and run it from the command prompt, okay? Now you can write in the program using any text editor. For the simplicity purpose, I'm going to use the Notepad, which is available in all edition of Windows. Okay, now let's type in a simple C program. Now I'm not going to explain the program here because I have already made a video and explained all these things. If you want, you can watch that video. Okay, let's include the stdio.h header file so that we can access the input and output operations. So hash include stdio.h, and then we will write the main function, which will be the starting point of our program from our perspective, from the programmer's perspective. And let's return 0. That's because, you know, we are saying that this main function is returning an integer value. And then let's use the printf function and let's print out some text. For example, let's say hello world. Okay, now we need to save this program. So I'm gonna go to file, save, and I'm gonna save this program in my desktop. I'll create a new folder in my desktop and I'm gonna call it as C. And then here, let's give a name, hello world. And then the file extension should be .c, and then click on this save. Okay, now we have the program hello world.c. Now we will compile and run this program from the command prompt. Now I have saved that program in my desktop inside this C folder. If I open up that folder, you guys can see hello world.c file in here. Okay, you guys can see this hello world.c file in here. Now I want to open up the command prompt in this location. So I'm gonna go to this URL section or the address bar or whatever we call it. And then I'm gonna left click here and then I'll type in CMD. Okay. And then if I hit the enter button, the command prompt will be opened in this location. Okay. Now you guys can see here, C users, Anil Shetty, desktop, and then C folder. Now from here, if I write in the command dir, then you know it will list out all the files and folders present in this folder, which is C folder, which is in the desktop. You guys can see hello world.c file. Okay, now let's generate the executable file from this hello world.c. So for the GCC toolset, you need to use the command gcc, and then you need to provide the name of the file, which is hello world.c. Okay, now if I hit the enter button, nothing happens. But if you look at the folder here, then you guys can see a new file is created with a.exe. Now here in this command prompt, while writing this command, we have not specified the file name for the executable file generated. And if you don't provide the name for the executable file, then by default that name will be ye. And the executable file in the Windows environment will have .exe extension, and you guys can see ye.exe here. Okay. Now here, what we have done is we have used just one command, and this one command will perform all the steps from pre-processing, compilation, linking. It will perform all those steps and it will generate the executable file. Now, if you want to run this program, then we need to run this executable file. Here you guys can see a.exe. So I will type in a here in this command prompt, and you guys can see here, we get the output hello world. Now, what if you want to give the name for the executable file? Now, one thing that you can do is you can go here and rename the file. You know, you can do that, but while writing this command, you know, you can specify the name for the executable file which has been generated. And to do that, we have to type in the command gcc then minus o, which means that I want to give a name for the executable file, and then we need to give the name for the executable file. So here, let's say hello.exe. Okay, that's going to be the name of the executable file. And then we need to specify the file which is containing the source code, which is hello world.c. Okay, now if I hit the enter button, nothing happens here, but here But here in this folder, you guys can see hello.exe. So the executable file generated has a name now, which is hello, which we have specified here. Now, if you want to run this program, then all you have to do is type in hello. That's it. You will get the output. Okay. Now, this is how you guys can compile and run a C program from the command prompt. Now, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, then hit the dislike button. If you want to say something, then write that in the comment box. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.